music used to make me smile. And I knew if I had my chance that I could make those people dance, and maybe they'd be happy for a while. But February made me shiver with every paper I'd deliver. Bad news on the doorstep.
Hey guys, got a kukri in the background there. Really, really cool fixed blade knife, but we're not going to talk about that today. We're going to talk about this knife here. This is a really nice Thomas Turner single blade regular jackknife, and it is pretty nice. So we'll just zoom a bit. Okay. And what you have here is a knife that is 4 1/8 inches, single blade, smooth, natural bone there, with carbon steel liners, carbon steel pins, and carbon steel bolsters. And this is a triple crimped bolster. Pretty cool. Pretty cool there. Very nicely done. In fact, so nicely done that the top edges of this are kind of sharp. Not really sharp, but you know, you feel them. You feel them. And they were really well done. Look at that. Just great job on making that. And we'll open up the knife, and you can see Thomas Turner Cutlers to His Majesty. That's pretty cool, right? You have a monarch's mark on it, and on the back you see Encore beneath the trademark of Thomas Turner in Sheffield. This knife is solid knife. So get that kukri out of there. Really nice. It's a spear point. I call those thin spear point blades. And back in the 1800s, the blades are just a little thinner. And towards the end of the 1800s, they started getting a little thicker. And it's one indication of an early knife, these thin spear point blades here. You can see, you know, it's not even as big as my finger. And I want to talk just a minute here about this mark. Cutlers to His Majesty. So only a handful of cutlers were able to put this mark on their knives. It came from a royal proclamation that allowed them to do that, and it really benefited a cutler to be associated with. What it means is that Thomas Turner provided cutlery to the monarchy. And so this really can help you figure out the age of a knife. And so in the 1800s, early in the 1800s, from 1800 to 1830, England had a male monarch, which this is to His Majesty. And after 1837, Queen Victoria ruled, and that would be to Her Majesty. And so that's gives you some indication of the age of the knife. The problem with that is that Queen Victoria ruled up to 1901. So after 1901, they had male monarchs again. And so this knife could come from the time period between 1901 or up, you know, post 1901, or it could be a pre 1837 knife. And so when you look at the back, in 1890, it was required that a England stamp be put in there. So as a general rule, this is not hard and I'll explain why, but as a rule of thumb, this knife would come before 1890, would have been made before 1890. If that is the case, then a reference to His Majesty would refer to the time of male monarchs in England, and that would be pre-1837. So before 1837, they had male monarchs, King George and then King Henry. And then after 1837, you had Queen Victoria. And so if it was to Her Majesty, it would refer to Queen Victoria. Now, there is an exception, and that's why I called the England mark rule of thumb. So knives produced for domestic consumption in England did not have to be marked England. So that's the thing you have to remember is you still have to do a little bit of homework to figure out when your knife was made. But in this case, Goins puts this mark as 1837, 1822 to 1837 is what Goins puts this mark at. And for me, there are a lot of indicators on this knife that indicate that it's an older knife. And I'll just show you, run those real quick to you. So if you look at these pins, that one's pretty good. This one, not as good. So they're pretty symmetrical, but they're not perfect, okay? And so English knives did better on their pens. They hammered these pens in than, say, early American or German. But you can see it's not perfect, right? And if you, that one is almost rectangular, if you look at it. And if you look at pens from the early 20th century, they're just perfectly round, right? So they had made a lot of progress in making those pens perfect. So the pens kind of indicate that they're older 18th century. Then the fact that it's natural bone is an indication. Even though you can find plenty of natural bone in the beginning of the 20th century, this was much more prominent in the early 1800s, natural bone. They weren't jigging bone as much. And then the fact that you have three crimps here, that's another early indication of a knife made in the early to mid 1800s. You can still find triple crimped knives later. You know, it's just an indication. It's not a guarantee. Three crimps doesn't mean it was made in the mid 1800s. It's just they were more prominent then. Okay. So if you take that, all those indications together, you know, it just indicates an older knife. And I think this knife is probably made between 1830 and 1837 in the reign of King Henry, I would say. And just pretty good, cool knife, and a little bit of history on how to figure out that His Majesty thing. And I hope you enjoyed the video. Get the camera on the knife. Okay? And if you did, go ahead and like it. And if you'd like to see more content like this and really astounding, informative, factual information, go ahead and subscribe. And remember, you shall know the truth. The truth shall set you free. And thanks so much, guys, for watching the video.